Hello guys, in this video I will be telling you about the basics of React and we will be learning about JSX, which is similar to HTML. So first of all, let us see how we can start a React app. So this is the basic React app that I have created. In order to start it, you need to go to the terminal and new terminal. Make sure you are in your project directory, which is same as this. Okay, so here you can run the command npm run dev. So let me just copy it and hit enter. As you can see, my React app has started on this URL. So you can go to this URL. So let me just copy it. Let's go there. So here you can see my React app is running. Great. So this hello text is coming from here actually. So the thing you see here, this div and h1, it is very similar to HTML, right? So this is nothing but JSX. It is slightly different from HTML that we will see as we progress. Okay. So you can hide this if you want. Great. So you can write code like native HTML. Like suppose you want to add a paragraph to this, you can just write p tag and whatever text you want. And if you save your file now, let me do it. And here, as you can see, the text has appeared. So this is how you can write HTML in a React. So basically this app is nothing but a component that is rendered here. So whatever you can see, this is actually a function. We will be learning about component in later video, but let us try to understand this. Whatever we are returning from here in this form will be rendered here. So if I suppose place a button here and save the changes, you can see the button has been created here. Okay, so in order to learn it more efficiently, I am creating a sample app. Suppose we are creating a very simple website with a navbar at top, some content in the middle and some footer at the bottom. Very basic layout suppose we are creating. So how we can do it in a React app? So let us try to do this. Okay, so first of all, let us create the nav bar. So in generally we can use a nav element, or we can also use a div element. Okay, so suppose we have a logo and some text here. So for now I am just creating an h1. Suppose logo is there. And then I also have some text like the brand or company brand. Okay, so let us see how this looks. So this looks something like this, because h1 is a block element and they are occupying their own lines. Okay, we will worry about styling a bit later, but let's for now create the markup. Okay, so we have our navigation bar, then we want suppose the main content. Let us create another div here, and I am just creating some content like we have heading and we have a paragraph tag in that between below it. So we can just duplicate this. Okay, so now we can have a footer maybe. So let us have a footer tag, or you can create some more tag. I am just showing the example here. So inside footer, suppose we have some links maybe, like we have some, let's do keep things simple and paragraph here. Like suppose we have home and then we have some contact and some about page here maybe. So this is just for demonstration. So here you can see it is rendered like this. Let us apply some basic styling so that it is easier for us to see. So how can we apply a styling in React app? So normally we use class names in native HTML. Suppose we want to target this div, then we use class name on it and we can style it. Similarly, we can also do this in React. Let me show you how. So if you see, there is a file called app.css and I am importing it here. So basically this file is imported here, so I can access the classes of this site in this file. Okay, so let me show you how. Suppose there is already a class called app which is applying a padding. So let us see how we can use this. So normally, let us say inside this div, normally in HTML we do class, right? This, but in JSX we have to use class name. Okay, because of some naming collisions it is there. Most of the attributes are same, almost 90% attributes are same, some are different, so one of them is class name. So just instead of class you need to use class name. So if I apply app class here, let me save it, and as you can see the padding has been applied here. Earlier it was not there. Okay, let us apply some more styles. Suppose in navbar I can create a class of navbar maybe, and in this I can create a class of main. Suppose main content, and finally we have a class for footer. Let me apply some basic styling in all these three classes. So let me just move it here so we can see both. Okay, so let us target this navbar class here. So first of all, let us change the background color. Let us say light blue. So here you can see, like normal CSS, we are able to apply class names and we are able to target these classes. So let us suppose I want this side by side. So what we can do is we can use a flex box. We can set the display to flex and we can define a gap. So if you say there is no gap, they are aligned but there is no gap, so we can specify a gap, let us say 16 pixels. Here you can see I'm not focusing on the styling much, I'm just doing the basic styling only. So let us target this another one and we will give a different color so we are able to distinguish. Backgrounds, let's say light, maybe this one. And finally we also have footer class here. Okay, so this is how our app looks like. So we can give a space between these elements. So what we can do, either we can target this div and make this div as a flex box so that we can give space between their children, and we can also give margin or padding. Let me show you how we can use flex box. So we can set the display of flex. I am doing it in app because here you can see this div element is the parent of all three. So this navbar, this main content and footer are children. So I am creating this div as a flex box. So by default flex box aligns by row. We can change the direction to column. So now it is black, but here we can now give a gap. So let me give something like 100 pixels. So here you can see 100 is bit more, let me say 50. So now we are able to distinguish between all three of them. This is just for, you know, so that we are able to distinguish. So this is how we can write JSX in React, and this is how we can apply styling to it. This is basic level of styling. Another method is of styling is by using CSS modules that we will be learning in future, but for now this is okay. Next thing, the advantage of, you know, JSX is that we can use variable names here. So actually this here you can see it is actually a JavaScript file. JSX basically means it, we can write JavaScript as well as HTML in there. So this is the advantage of it. Here you can see this is a function like a JavaScript, but here we are able to write HTML also. So this is actually a combination of both. So let me create a variable here, just like we do in a normal JavaScript. So we can say const name assign. Let us say the name is XYZ. And here we can also create age like 21. Okay. So now suppose you want to display the name somewhere. For example, in where do we say in this head, after this heading, suppose you want to display your name. So what you can do is enter this JavaScript mode. Okay. So this is actually HTML. Okay. This H3 is like an HTML, but we are entering a JavaScript mode by using curly braces. So here we can specify this variable that will be rendered here. Let me show you. I can specify the name here. So if I save this, here you can see the XYZ has appeared. So whatever be the value in name, suppose Rohan, it will be displayed here. So this is the beauty of JSX. We just need to write it once, and if we want to change the data, we can make it dynamic. Okay, so for now, maybe this is coming from a server. So we just need to use this variable here, and whatever the value in variable will be rendered here. Okay, so similarly, we can use age. Suppose I want to use age in this paragraph, or maybe this home. So again, I'm entering in JavaScript mode and using the variable. Here you can see the age is 21. Let me zoom in. Okay. Great.